Sean the Butcher. I am here trapped in quarantine, but it's all good because I'm here with one of my favorite dudes ever. The guttural screaming, kettlebell swinging, coffee drinking at this very moment. Billboard charting frontman of the Acacia Strain, one of the greatest bands of all time. I got Vincent Bennett. What is going on, Vincent?
Hi, Sean. Just hanging out. Sweating. I have my AC on, but it doesn't feel like it. It's like 100 degrees out right now.
Well, you look great. I like you in your blue cupcake shirt. You got your Coma Witch hat.
Yes.
You look about 100 pounds lighter. How much weight have you lost in this pandemic?
I haven't lost any weight in the pandemic.
Oh, my.
I'm maintaining right now. I'm doing just enough exercise to counteract the daily pizza that I eat. Because it's what else are you going to do? Yeah, I'm so bored. I'm just like ordering takeout I've never had before, like from these places I've never heard of before. So I'm just like, well, I support local business. Like, I feel good about myself. I'm just like, yeah, you know, it's just me supporting the small, you know, local business by ordering a pizza and stuffing my face every single
Getting
day.
Fat. So weren't you on doing the keto thing, or are you off the keto?
I did keto for a while. I'm still doing it, like, on and off. But like I said, it's like, I'm so fucking bored. And, like, keto is really good if you have access to a grocery store every single day.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really, like, I don't like going in public right now for obvious reasons, especially mm-hmm. the grocery store, where people were like, at the beginning of this, everyone was super cautious, but now everyone's too comfortable and they see the one-way signs on the floor, but they don't fucking care. They know that their nose is connected to their lungs, but they don't fucking care. Like nope. It's just like, so I'm just like staying away from the grocery store as much as I can and supporting my local small businesses by ordering pizza from them every single day.
Maybe breakfast, lunch, and dinner pizza.
Every once in a while, I get a salad, but that salad is topped with like six different kinds of meat and cheese.
So just cut up a pizza and throw it on the salad.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, how you holding up in the pandemic? How's everything doing? How's your mental health? What are you doing to like maintain positivity in this dark time we're in?
First and foremost, I have a Twitch stream where I stream almost every single day, and it keeps me like, because, you know, I'm not going to be able to tour. I'm supposed to be on tour right now. I'm not going to be able to tour for a while, probably. Mm-hmm. So I miss that, like, being in front of people and performing in front of people. So Twitch is, I guess, the second best thing. And it's not, you know, the numbers. It's not 200 to 500 people like it would be in an Acacia Strain show, but it's like 45, 50 people every single night. And I've kind of developed a community, and everybody has somebody to talk to, because, you know, this is the loneliest time to be a human being. Like, you mm-hmm. can't hang out with your friends. You can't talk to anybody. So I've developed this like kind of niche Acacia Strain / video game fan community, and everybody's become friends, and they're doing, you know, one dude, like, his power was out, and another dude in the chat was like, I got you, and like called the power company and was like complaining and like pretended to be like an important person and had this dude's power turned
no
back.
So
it's like,
way,
yeah, it's like really cool. So that's,
so this is
that's,
what you're doing on Twitch. You're doing video game streaming and stuff.
Yeah, I play video games, sometimes retro stuff, sometimes current stuff, but mainly I just talk, we just chat, you know. It's just me and people chatting mm-hmm. with a video game in the background. Sometimes I put Coco on, and, you know, so that's like the main
Your
thing I've been
Coco.
Doing. Exercise is really helpful. Having a routine is super helpful.
Yes.
Riding my bike has been really, like, I guess, meditative.
You said you did how many miles this week on your bike?
72 miles so far this
Psychotic
week.
Psychotic fuck.
I'm doing 18 miles a day. So I'm doing 7 days on, 7 days off, 7 days on, 7 days off.
Oh,
and
man.
7 days off from bike riding, I do kettlebells. So I'm doing mm-hmm. upper body 1 week, cardio the next, and vice versa. So,
well, you're keeping in shape for tour when you get back out there.
I don't want to be like pizza
old Vincent.
Yeah,
coming out looking like old Vincent. I've seen some old footage of you. Somebody posted it recently when you were like the size. I recently had pictures pop up of when I was interviewing you at like barbecues maybe 6-7 years ago, and you look like a completely different human being. It's great to see how you've not expanded, I guess, compacted in the last couple of years. So props to you on doing that.
Yeah, thank you. I was pushing 300 pounds. Now I'm hovering around 200. So
that's fucking sexy,
pretty,
man.
Pretty good. And it helps, like, it helps your mental too, because when you're, I mean, not that I'm not stuffing my face with fucking pizza
honestly,
but I'm doing things to help counteract that. And when your body is somewhat healthy, your brain follows, you know, and it helps you, especially right now, like it's super hard to just be sane because everyone is arguing. Even people who agree with one another are arguing with themselves. Like there's infighting, there's outfighting, there's all this fucking crazy, all sorts of crazy shit. Anytime I don't look, I'm trying to like bury my head in the sand. I know it's like stupid and ignorant, but like I can't look at the news.
Sometimes it's not worth it to jump into that shit.
Because it gives me fucking, I have panic attacks sitting on my couch, which is supposed to be my fortress of solitude. And I'm like, why is this?
Death, destruction, problems, horror. Yeah, it's horrible. It's
nothing
horrible
I can do about it. You know,
but what we have is positivity coming out of all this with the release of this brand new record.
Yeah.
Slow Decay, out now. Brand new music from the Acacia Strain. It's out on Rise Records. And the birth of this happened over a while, because I remember when you were on tour with Knocked Loose. Right. And I was talking to you about what was going on. You guys recorded two full albums in your last visit to the studio.
We almost killed Tom.
Yeah. And that's another thing I want to get into is this brilliant musician, Tom, you have working for you. Mm-hmm. But you recorded both of these albums. You released the first part as a 30-minute long song right after Christmas. It was a birthday present from the Acacia Strain to their fans. I have been up your ass for years, ever since you put out The Observer on Coma Witch, a 27-minute masterpiece. I've always been like, Vincent, when are you hitting us with another half-hour song? It's been years. Yeah. What made you guys want to come out and record this 30-minute song and put it out to the masses?
That was something that we had talked about it for a long time. Like, as you said, we were just like, I've been talking about it. We've been talking about it forever. And we actually started writing it like 2 years ago. And it just kind of put on the back burner for a while because we were touring really heavily. And finally, when we finally got the okay from the label, I told Justin, I was like, listen, man, you have to give us a deadline or it's never going to get done.
Yeah.
So
Justin Loudon, Closed Casket Activities.
We had just started a tour with Knocked Loose. And Justin was like, all right, I want it done by the end of tour. And we were just like, fuck. So like every single day, Tom, Griffin, and Devin were in the dressing room. As soon as we finished loading in, they were writing recording the in the green room. Sick. They would days off, we would get an Airbnb and they would set up the recording rig and they would record in the Airbnb. They had no fun all tour. They were just recording that record all tour. And I was like, yeah, I'll get to it whenever. And then when tour was over, I was like, fuck, now it's my turn. So I had to write lyrics. I had to put the lyrics together. And I recorded everything in my friend's attic. My friend Mike, who used to play guitar for a Muir, he has like a small recording rig in his attic, like 20 minutes away from where I live. So it was perfect. So I went there like every day for a week, recorded vocals, got it done, sent it to Justin. He was like, yeah, awesome. There's a problem with pressing. And we were just like, fuck. And we had no idea when it was going to come out. And he hit us up in like November and was like, yeah, it looks like it's going to come out around Christmas time. Do you want to announce it? And we were like, no, let's just keep this whole thing a secret and not tell anybody. And a few media channels got a hold of that idea, but no one really gave a shit. Mm-hmm. And so it was still a surprise to a lot of people. And I think it was just cool because we just wanted to do something kind of out of our comfort zone. And we wanted to do something that like wasn't necessarily like Acacia Strain. You know, we wanted to see what we could do, push ourselves to like this area that we've never really been to before. And that's like Tom's first time writing for the band. Mm-hmm. He was like super stressed out. And I was like, listen, man, write whatever you want. Don't give a fuck. It's not Acacia Strain. Okay, don't even think. This is Tom and Griffin and Devin. This is not Acacia Strain. Just write what you want. And he was like, okay, I'm just going to write what I want. And he did. And they all did. And it all came together. And I think that method of thinking where it was like, just throw everything you know about the Acacia Strain out the window is how it really came to full like fruition, I guess. Mm-hmm. And it feels good. And because of that, we were like, wow, like people liked it. We didn't expect anyone to like it. We just were going to put it out.
Didn't even give a shit.
Who gives a shit about this? And people enjoyed it. And we were like, I guess we can do whatever the hell we want now. And we did.
And you did just that right after you released that. Immediately after, EPs started popping out. And I was like, oh my God, what is this? So the 30-minute long song from the Acacia Strain, it was on the album, It Comes in Waves. It was broken into 7 parts. Our only sin was giving them names.
Yeah.
Then you have this other record popping out, I think the middle of January, the first 2 songs were released, and it's released on an EP with 1 letter. And I was like, okay, my interest is piqued because I know you're going to be spelling something out, which means there's more EPs on the way. What made you guys want to go through this whole process of putting out the album as an EP instead of a full album right off the bat?
So this is another thing we've wanted to do for a long time. Like, so I mentioned that I started recording vocals when we got off the Knock Loose tour. I started recording vocals in June. Everybody else in the band was writing this record as I was recording vocals. And we just kept going because we had a studio date of September. So we just had to get it done. And super stressful. I don't recommend ever doing this. Because we wanted to release
the best way to work under stress.
We wanted to release the EPs like one at a time, but we had to book all the studio time at once because going in every 2 months to record 2 songs is just like pain in the ass.
Not gonna happen. Yeah.
So we had to write and record a full length. And I've always wanted to kind of reminisce about, you know, everybody wants to reminisce about the old days, but nobody wants to do anything about it except start a band that sounds exactly like a band from the old days. Mm. So I remember when I was like 16, when I first got the ability to drive or have friends who drove, we'd go to the record store once a week, maybe twice a week. We would go to the record store. And every time I went to the record store, I would go to the 7-inch section because they were like $3. It was the easiest way to get new music from the bands that you liked. And I noticed that every week I went, there was new stuff from the same bands that I loved. And it was awesome because there wasn't MP3s. There was no way to download music. There was no fucking CDs was it. So the only way, CDs and records. So the only way for a band to get new music out there, instead of just putting 2 songs out at a time on Spotify, they had to release a 7-inch. So I would find $3 2-song 7-inches from Coalesce and Get Up Kids and all this other stuff. Mm-hmm. And I'd be pumped. And I kind of wanted to recreate that feeling. I'm the oldest person in the band. So I'm the only person that, you know, Griffin's old, so he kind of remembers it too, but I'm the only person that actually kind of remembers this feeling. And I wanted to recreate it, not only for the people my age and older, but for the people who never really got to experience that, who lived in the MySpace era, who grew up with Spotify, and recreate this feeling of physical media coming out piecemeal, you know? And it had to be special. It had to be, I know Acacia Strain fans because I am one. And if a band that I loved was releasing stuff like every couple weeks with a letter attached to it, where you had to get every letter in order to have the full collection, like I would freak the fuck out. I'm doing that. Look at this. These are all 7-inches. Those are all 7-inches down there, you know? So I collect and I know collectors and I get it. So just to have something cool like that, it was just fun to do. And people were telling me, like, I feel like it's Christmas. And I never know, because we never released, like, it's coming out every 4 weeks. We staggered the releases. Yep. So sometimes it was 3, sometimes it was 5, sometimes it was 4. So every time one came out, people were like, this is
new present. Yep, so that's how fun. I woke up every day. Oh, a new present from the Acacia Strain. Yeah. I can't fucking wait to hear this new song. Hell yeah.
A lot of people didn't have the foresight that you did and were like, didn't buy D. They have EC.
So they have EK.
They have EK and don't have D, and it's bugging the shit out of them. And people are being actual scumbags and putting up the D record alone for like $100+.
Well, of course.
Like, come Welcome on, like this is Welcome supposed to be a, this is supposed to be a fun thing with the community, and no. You guys suck.
Nothing can be fun. Nothing can be fun.
Nothing can be fun.